GM fam, and thank you for joining us to take a look at the wacky and wild world of crvUSD arbitrage trading. Of course, we recommend arbitrage trading actually only be executed by experienced professionals in consultation with your lawyers. It's a very, very complex subject, so everything we're presenting here is entirely educational in nature because crvUSD does in fact rely on arbitrage trading to help reinforce its peg, so we thought that the entire community could benefit from a look under the hood at what's going on with some of these arbitrage trades. We're going to presume that you already have a basic understanding of crvUSD architecture. If not, we highly recommend that you check the GitHub white paper, which goes into extreme detail about all of these. The important thing about the crvUSD architecture is that each type of collateral has its own AMM attached to it. This AMM functions just like a traditional curve pool. You can transact between the tokens within it, and in this case, the tokens within it are going to be whichever collateral type it is. At launch for curve, this has been SFRAX ETH and crvUSD. It's also got a bunch more going on. It connects, of course, to the crvUSD stablecoin. It's got this PegKeeper, which is actually keeping track of the prices of these assets and adjusting the entire borrowing supply rate throughout the entire ecosystem. But we don't need to deal with all of this. The way that we're going to be running our arbitrage trades is we're going to be launching and deploying an arbitrage.vy Viper script. This is a very helpful script that's actually going to sit on-chain and calculate if there are arbitrage opportunities, and if there are, it's going to take a crack at executing them. So you can see that this plugs in by connecting directly with the LLAMMA AMM and the crvUSD stablecoin, and it's also going to interface with some FRAX and Curve existing architecture. For FRAX, because we're using the SFRAX ETH as collateral, it is the capability of taking FRAX ETH and minting it as XFRAX ETH. And on the Curve side, it's going to use the Curve router to route through other existing Curve pools to see if there's, in fact, arbitrage opportunities based on the pricing of the assets in those pools. And finally, within the GitHub repository, we have both the arbitrage.vy script and a helper arbitrage.py script, which we're not talking about in this video. But this arbitrage.py script is just going to deploy, use this arbitrage.vy as a means of testing and probing if there's an opportunity, and if there is, it will have the capability of executing it. So all that's in the companion GitHub repository. We're not going to code it from scratch, but we're going to walk through some of the key highlights of how it works. Within the arbitrage smart contract, there's two major functions as well as a few peripheral but fairly unimportant admin functions. The bread and butter of this, though, is there's a view function called calc output, which is used to estimate the potential output amount of any arbitrage opportunity, and an exchange function that's going to actually execute the strategy. So looking at how this calc output works, we've included some extensive documentation, and don't be scared off too much by it. A lot of this is just the swap parameters that are passed to the curve exchange contracts. And these look complex, but the helper script actually helps you to populate them. The important piece is just conceptually what's going on. So what's most important is this liquidation flag. There's two directions that arbitrage opportunities can run. You can be liquidating collateral, that is, in this case, turning SFRAX ETH into crvUSD, or you can go the other direction. You can turn crvUSD back into SFRAX ETH. The way that arbitrage trading works is we're going to supply a type of collateral, and in the end, we're going to receive that same collateral back. So if we're in a liquidation route, as you can see on line 107 here, you're taking the collateral, you're putting it into the curve exchange router, and through the classic curve pools that exist through the interface, you're trading that collateral for crvUSD. You then take that crvUSD, put it in the LLAMMA, get your collateral back, and calculate the amount. If it's bigger, that is, you got more collateral out than you put in, then you've just successfully arbitrated. Similarly, you can run a deliquidation on this. You can take collateral, put it in the LLAMMA, get crvUSD out, take that crvUSD, put it back in the router, and hope you get more collateral out. If either of these is positive, that is potentially free money. So that's what gets arbitrators quite excited. You'll note that in this case, we're just calling view functions on this. So we're calling, for example, get dx dy or get exchange multiple amount to see what the theoretical values would be. If you want to run it, though, the script is surprisingly similar. Instead of running this and just getting view amounts out, we're actually redeeming it. So in this first case of liquidation, we're taking SFRAX ETH, redeeming it as FRAX ETH, running that through the router, exchanging, and then running that through the LLAMMA and running the exchange, or vice versa if you're deliquidating. So this is actually making it happen and making your money. You'll note that the structure is just the exact same, except you're using real money instead of play money. Most of the time, you're going to not be successful. It's really tough to execute an arbitrage because it's player versus player. There's a lot of other arbitrators out there that are going to pounce on any opportunities. So you'll note most of the time, if you're running the Python script, you're just getting no liquidation arbitrage. And you know, if you look, gas costs can get quite substantial. In this case, estimating it, it looked like the 100 Gwei gas prices that CurveUSD was enjoying around its launch, it was costing like 0.03 Ethereum to run this. So you have to make more than 0.03 in order to actually make profit off of this. It means that when gas prices are low, you're actually going to see arbitrage happen, arbitrage trades happen for much smaller amounts, whereas when gas is higher, you're going to see fewer arbitrage trades, and they're going to be for higher amounts. We did manage to snap what this would look like in a successful event. In this case, in this fictitious scenario, there was a liquidation event going on with TUSD. That's the TUSD CurveUSD pool. It was, in this case, based on the collateral put in, able to capture an expected collateral profit of 1.01 SFRAX ETH, which is pretty good. Even with gas prices around 0.03, you got to kind of run that, right? We also snapped through EigenFi what this would look like in the wild. This is a service that EigenFi provides to visualize complex transactions. It's absolutely gorgeous, highly recommended. In this case, you can see the user at step zero is depositing 45 SFRAX ETH to the contract. The contract then took it, and this whole mess up in the upper left is Curve Exchange Contracts Land. So it basically takes the SFRAX ETH, deposits and returns for 87,000 CurveUSD, takes the CurveUSD, dumps it into a different Curve Viper contract. Here, runs through the exchange and receives 47 FRAX ETH back. But remember, we need to get into SFRAX ETH, so it then takes it, deposits it to SFRAX ETH. The 47 FRAX ETH turns into 45.3, and in this case, the arbitrage trader was able to make a clean 0.2824 SFRAX ETH in profit. Not bad. Again, very risky. What happens if you're competing with other people for these opportunities can get very complicated, but we would like to open it now for questions. And while we open it for questions, we would like to remind you that if you'd like to learn more about anything that Curve is doing, the Curve GitHub repository is a fantastic resource.